Who is this dude? What up? It's the Trooper. I am on the strip, but not for long, and there's a good reason for that. If I didn't have a good reason to be on the strip, I wouldn't be on the strip today. F1 has everything F1'd up across the city. It's ridiculous. So I decided to try some local poker. Some of the local casinos. Casinos that aren't on the strip. Maybe even casinos that are on Las Vegas Boulevard, but not on the strip per se. Video out here on the street doesn't really do it justice. You kind of have to drive to see what the chaos is all about. At least it's not hot on the strip anymore. It's a lovely 68 degrees, but still, let's give local poker a try. As you know, I almost invariably play poker on the strip, including Westgate, which I guess you could say the Westgate is not on the strip, but it is within reach of the strip. But I have decided to try a little bit of this local poker action. Places that are mostly frequented by people who live here in Vegas. Today I'm at the South Point. Let's go check it out and see what's going on. I know they got a Starbucks here. Waiting for a seat. This seems to be moving. I think I'm number 4 on the list at the moment. Found the Starbucks action. It's actually made pretty well. It was just an Americano though. They didn't have the pumpkin cream cold brew that I wanted, but hey, what are you gonna do? So that was actually kind of fun. One thing I like about places like South Point is that they have sort of an old school feel. South Point has kind of an old school feel. There was an interesting scenario, interesting story, semi-interesting anyway. I was just about to rack up to leave when I played one of the last couple hands that I would be playing. I was in seat 1, and the guy in seat 3, he was in town for Halloween. He was definitely having fun. He was on his way to Fremont Street. He was just playing poker for a little while until he headed down there. And he was definitely having fun. And seat nine, who also seemed to be from out of town, which is funny that I called it local poker, but I think he was from out of town as well. And whatever, they were in hand. Long story short, the flop was five king king with the king five of hearts. And the turn card was a king and the river card was the deuce of hearts. So there were three kings on the board and three hearts on the board. And I didn't really pay attention to the hand until showdown. Seat three showed queen nine of hearts for a flush. And about the time that the dealer called out the hand that he had a flush, seat nine flipped his cards over and they landed on the felt. I watched them land on the felt. It was ace deuce. So he had rivered a full house. But as his cards hit the felt and he heard the dealer say flush, he picked his own cards up and mucked them. The dealer pushed the pot to the guy with the flush in seat three, but as seat nine was picking up his own hand and putting it face down, I could have sworn I saw a deuce. It was indeed ace deuce. And as they were pushed into the muck and the pot was pushed and the board was scooped, the guy on my left, we looked at each other. We thought we saw a full house. And then I said, did he have a deuce? And then the dealer overheard me, but wasn't really sure. I looked over and it looked like seat eight noticed and said something. And we were at a point of letting it go, but because I saw seat eight and then seat seven also seemed to be noticing, somehow someone said something, which you're supposed to do, by the way. If the hand is tabled and the dealer is pushing the pot the wrong way, you kind of have a duty to say something as a player in the game. Four came over. And the way the dealer told the story is that the guy showed his hand, but kept his cards in his hand and then turned it over face down or whatever. The floor was like, did anyone else see the cards leave the player's hands face up? So in other words, did the player table the hand, not just show the hand, but table the hand? And the floor's right. I was the only one. The floor was like, there's only one person saying that they left his hand, that they were tabled, because this is not tabling your hand. And honestly, the guy who got the pot was confused. The guy who showed his hand, he realizes he had a full house at this point, but he doesn't remember for sure if he tabled his hand. They were about to let the guy keep the pot, and then the floor was like, all right, here's what we do. How much was the pot? $40. Give me $40. We'll put it to the side. We'll go to the cameras, and we'll see for sure what happened. Only one guy, and that guy was me, is saying that the back of the guy's cards touched the table. He released the cards onto the table. Well, you probably realize by now that I'm right. The floor came over about 10 minutes later and said, yep, he did show his hand. He did have a full house. He did table it and release it onto the table before he picked it back up and turned it face down. So they awarded the pot to the guy, rightfully, who had the full house. The guy who had the flush was, had a good attitude about it. And although it wasn't just me. There were other people who saw the deuce, but I was the only one who was adamant about them being properly tabled, although seat seven was on my side. A bet was made. Seat seven bet that he did table his hand and he won. So there you go. Interesting little situation. Always remember that in order for your hand to be tabled, they have to be released onto the felt face up. And always pay attention. And always speak up, because cards speak. And if the guy who had the full house didn't notice he had a full house, and if the dealer didn't see it, and if everyone else thought that the flush won at the moment, cards speak. In other words, cards speak for themselves, and if anyone saw that mistake, they should say something. Yeah. Golly, it's chilly out here, y'all. We're looking at 63 degrees right now. I end up winning $51. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. No drive-by. I'll see you next time.